Hello and welcome. My name is Xander. Welcome to the ORM Mastery course, Level 1 for Beginners. In this tutorial, we explore many-to-many relationships. Here we try to define a set of fields that represent relations using a many-to-many relationship. Just briefly, for anyone new to this playlist, this tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. And then finally, before we start the tutorial, if you like this tutorial and would like to learn more, please check out our Django Database ORM Mastery course on Udemy. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Course thumbnails may change over time, so please check out for created by Very Academy. A many-to-many relationship occurs when, for example, one product is associated to multiple categories. So for one product, it might be part of multiple categories. So for example, you might have two categories in the category table, shoe and woman's shoe. And it might be that that product is related to shoe and also woman's shoe, for example. So that's a one-to-many relationship here between product and category. Now, the thing is, one category could be associated to multiple products. So we now have on the way back one category to multiple products. So what we have here is a many-to-many relationship. So by default, Django, when we create a many-to-many relationship, it will create a new table, a link table, sometimes it can be referred to, between the two tables. And what happens here is you can see two foreign keys are generated from the link table, one over to the product table and one over to the category table. So this is all generated for us. Django will automatically define the name of the table. It would take the name of the app, the name of the first table and the name of the second table and use underscores to break up the words. You can see that it has an auto incrementing ID, and the foreign key ID, obviously here, product one, would then be related to category one. And then obviously what we can now have is then product one here, a new record would then be connected to category two. So by creating this, we can create data to represent the fact that this product is part of multiple categories, and one category could be connected to multiple products. We can create this link table ourselves manually. That's going to be out of the scope of this tutorial. We look at that at level two. So in this tutorial, we'll just focus on Django generating the link table for us. So this is really simple. In the products table, I'm going to create, now you might not have a set of tables, so you may need to generate the tables yourself if you haven't been following step by step. So I'm going to create a new entry here, this category. So at the moment, we've got a foreign key over to that table. So I'm going to change that now, and I'll copy that and just keep that there for reference. So I'm going to change it now and turn that into a many-to-many field. So it's just going to be a simple case of typing in many-to-many here. And then we just need to define what table we're connected to, and that's going to be the category table. And there we go. So that's the basics of creating a many-to-many field. So let's go ahead and go into the migrations. Let's get rid of all the migrations. Let's get rid of the existing database. Let's close the server, Control C. Let's Command K on that if you're using Mac to clear the terminal. And then let's go ahead now and make migrations. And then once we've done that, let's go ahead and now migrate. And that then reapplies everything. And then finally, so we can access the admin, let's go for create super user. So admin, let's do that again. Admin, enter, admin, admin, yes. Okay, so now we can go ahead and run the server, run server, and let's take a look. All right, so let's go back into the admin area. We need to log in again. Okay, so we now have a many-to-many connection from products to categories. So there isn't really any restrictions here. So let's go ahead and add product, blah, blah. So we're not going to define any categories. Put the age in. And you can see that we can enter. Well, we can't. Please create below. So it needs to be part of a category. So we are enforcing the fact that it must be part of a category. So we can't have blank by default, at least. We can't have a null field. So we are going to need a category to be connected to. So let's go ahead and make category cat one. And let's go back into the products here. So let's select the category and then let's give that a name. Let's press save. And there we go. So you can see that this product is now part of one category. Well, we want it part of two categories. So let's create a new category here and press save. And so this is category object two. So let's go back to products here. And we can also now define and add that too. So let's add, So let's just make sure it's also assigned to that. Press save. Okay, so let's now go back into our database and take a look at the linked table. So for this, we're going to use SQLite extension. Let's just do a refresh. We'll go over to the right table. That's going to be, notice here we have the inventory product category table. That table has been created. Remember, that's the link table between the product and the category table. So let's have a look at showing the table, and you can now see our product one is associated to category one and category two. Now, if you weren't too sure there, what I did was I essentially just highlighted everything and press save to make it part of two categories there. So hold down control or command on a Mac to select more than one.